Dear people of God of Trinity, before you begin this worship service, I need for you to know that the words and songs and message were all put together before the unfolding of all of the horrendous events of this past week in the Twin Cities. A man has been brutally murdered, and the Twin Cities are now being destroyed. As I sit here, I can smell the burning plastic just up the road a few miles on University Avenue in St. Paul. I don't want to worship today. I want to sit with the Psalms of lament and ask, why, O Lord, why? And if you choose to not worship and to also sit with those words of lament, I understand. On the other hand, we need to breathe. We all have to breathe every day. And when Jesus breathed the Holy Spirit on his disciples and on us, he gave us a wonderful gift. And we need to depend on the strength of that Spirit every day to face the challenges that come at us, seemingly on a daily basis. So, good people, however you choose to worship, I pray that the Spirit of love and grace and power will surround you. Welcome to worship, Trinity of Hammond. I'm so glad that you have chosen to worship today, wherever you happen to be right now. Today is Pentecost Sunday. 50 days following Easter, the Holy Spirit arrived with great drama, tongues and flames of fire over people's heads, people speaking in different languages, all for the purpose of sending people out with the power of the Holy Spirit to all of the world to tell about the love of Christ. I'm glad that you're here, and I hope that you enjoy worship and receive the breath of the Spirit. And a special thank you today to Sarah, to Nolan, and to Darcy for their help.
Prayer of the day. Oh God, on this day you open the hearts of your faithful people by sending into us your Holy Spirit. Direct us by the light of that Spirit, that we may have a right judgment in all things and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Good morning. Welcome to worship today. Beautiful day and the sun's out finally. We have had a heck of a lot of rain. And as you just saw in the picture before, it was pretty threatening. Kind of feels like it is right now, going through this COVID crisis and all the turmoil in the world and the protests in Minneapolis. And I just want to let you know that the sun will come out again. And we just have to know that God is with us all the time. The Holy Spirit fell upon the disciples and the people at Pentecost, and that same Spirit lives in us, and that living water flows through our veins, and we just need to let it flow out through us and let God's power fill us and use us and give us hope.
The poor man say I am rich in him. Let the lost man say I am found in him. Oh. And let the river flow. Let the blind man say I can see again. Let the dead man say I am born again. lost man say I am found in him. And let the river flow. Let the blind man say I can see again. Let the dead man say I am born again.
First reading, Acts 2, verses 1 through 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya, belonging to Cyrene and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days, it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist." Psalm 104, verses 24 through 34. How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. There go the ships to and fro, and Leviathan, which you made for the sport of it. You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things. You send forth your spirit, and they are created, and so you renew the face of the earth. You look at the earth, and it trembles. You touch the mountains, and they smoke. May these words of mine please God. I will rejoice in the Lord. Second reading, 1 Corinthians verses 12-13. No one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge, according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body through many are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the Holy Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit.
I treasure the old hymns that I learned in my childhood. And this song was presented by our pastor, and you'll see it's one of the new ways that we're meeting together with people when we can't be together in person. Beautiful song, O Day Full of Grace. And listen to these words. They're so deep and rich, and they tell the story of what God did for us through Jesus Christ and sending us his Holy Spirit. O day full of grace.
Thank you.
reading from John chapter 20. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Happy Pentecost! There was a young woman who decided to serve God by teaching a Sunday school class. And she was great at finding the right kind of illustrations to tell the stories of Jesus and to give his life meaning for these kids. But when it came to Pentecost Sunday, she wasn't sure what to do to bring the story alive. So finally she went out and bought a bunch of red balloons, and she baked a cake and decided to have a party to celebrate the birthday of the church. So she told the kids the dramatic story of the Spirit coming, the flames of fire, people speaking in other languages, and then they celebrated with a cake and balloons, and they had a great time. Well, she felt pretty good about her class until she got a call later that afternoon from one of the little boys' mothers. "What did you teach those kids?" she said. "I heard that you talked about Santa Claus and that people's heads were burning, and then you had cake. So I just wondered what in the world you were telling these kids." Well, she was a little discouraged. She thought, she tried, but not everyone got the message. Well, it is a dramatic story, that coming of the Spirit. But we tend to think of that story in Acts as something that happened a long time ago, at a glorious moment in the past, but it doesn't really relate to our lives now. The story that we read in John chapter 20 is a little bit different. It happens on the very day of Jesus' resurrection, when he comes and stands with the disciples. And this account has to do with the very breath of life in our body, something that's as timely now as ever. Jesus comes, stands in the room where the disciples were gathered in fear. They were frightened. They thought the authorities were going to come looking for them to kill them too. But then Jesus does something amazing. He spreads out his hands to show them his wounds. And then he says, "Peace be with you." No doubt to calm their fears. And then we're told that he breathes on them. No dramatic winds of flames, but only the breath of Jesus. Now, when I hear that, the first thing that comes to my mind is that I really don't want anyone breathing on me at all. And I'm nervous about breathing on anyone else. I mean, only in the last few months have any of us given much thought about the aerosols that we breathe, and that if there's a coronavirus in them, they might get someone else sick. Only in recent days have we learned from health experts that breathing and singing together could be one of the most dangerous things that we can do when a group of people is gathered until this virus passes by. So my first response is, Jesus, maybe it would be better if you didn't stand so close to me. But of course, the truth is that Jesus doesn't breathe on us to make us sick. He breathes on the disciples and on us in this account to fill them with the Spirit. He knew that his time was coming to an end. And now he was giving to them what they needed so they could go out and do the works of God in all the earth. He breathed on them the talents and abilities and strength that they would need to go and bring his life. very breath is deep within us. It's the most essential thing to our life, right? We all have to breathe all the time, every day. And so for a moment, I'd like you to just stop and to focus on your breathing. I want you to take three very deep breaths. And as you breathe in, I want you to say, Jesus or Lord. And as you breathe out, say, have mercy. So let's just take three deep breaths. Actually, that's part of an ancient prayer called a breath prayer, where we invite Jesus to live within us and we breathe out his name as we go about our day. Studying the breath is what teachers of meditation do to help those who are anxious of mind and troubled of soul to find calm. Women who are in labor about to have a child study special breathing techniques so they can get through it. Those who have dealt with extreme anger or sometimes great trauma learn special breathing to help them so that they don't react in violence. I want you to think back about a time way back at the beginning of creation when the Creator put the very breath of life into the first man, Adam. Or when God came in the wind to speak to Job and reminded him that it was the Creator who gives breath to every human. Truly, it is our breath that can connect us again to the very source of life. Jesus, of course, knew all of that when he breathed on his chosen ones. And his breath was unlike any other breath because it was filled with a spirit that was holy. And both then and now, we would be dependent. He knew we would be dependent on that spirit to bring his goodness into the world. When we walk with Jesus, sharing his life with others is what brings us joy. We can't do that, sometimes we think, because we're restricted in what we do these days. But God's spirit isn't restricted to place. We can look around us and see what practical needs we can meet right now. Whenever we offer a cup of water in Jesus' name, we are giving from the breath of the Spirit. And when that Spirit moves, the results always involve life and joy and deeper understanding and better relationships. One of my great joys has been to travel and take groups on service trips. And always it seems that whatever we do, there's some sort of transformation of life that happens. 2 years ago, at the end of 2018, it was a thrill to go with a group to Puerto Rico, where we worked on housing rehab after Hurricane Maria. We worked on three different houses during the week in that area called Manabo, and some of our team met a man named Ben, and in his little house, they would get to know Ben as a friend while they worked. They learned in the course of their week that Ben had been a professional baseball player in the Puerto Rican leagues. And by the end of the week, they thought, what can we do to bring Ben a gift before we leave? Someone in the group was able to get hold of a baseball, and all of us signed it. And in a little ceremony, we presented it to Ben at the end of the week. We stood in his tiny home and prayed a blessing upon Ben. This is the work of the Spirit. These are the kinds of things that happen when Jesus breathes his Spirit breath on you. New joys, new experiences, people changed, lives altered for the better. Someone once said this: we Christians tend to be cautious folk. Too many churches have locked their doors to a vibrant understanding of the Holy Spirit's role in their midst. We don't know how to bear witness to Christ in a world populated by many religions and plagued by hypocrisy. Maybe it would inspire us to be bold if we saw the risen Jesus pass through our own doors. But probably all it takes is someone who can help us see that the same Jesus is already present, dwelling within us and eager to enlist us to carry on his work of setting people free. It's so true. Together, let's set the Spirit loose in our midst to see what wonders might happen. Let's act and pray with the assumption that Jesus has breathed on all of us and that we are free to share his breath of life everywhere we go. I pray that that would be reality for you as you breathe deep with his Spirit.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I
For God. Are you hungry for Him? Woo! More of Him. Who wants the floodgates to open up?
Let us pray. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. We call on your spirit of unity, giving thanks for our different vocations. Activate and utilize the diverse gifts present in your church, that they reveal your love for all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy Spirit, we call on your spirit of life, present in air, wind, humidity, storms, and oxygen, breathing energy into all things. Heal with your breath the whole creation, especially those who struggle to breathe due to pollution. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Holy Spirit, the one who fills us with the very breath of life, as we breathe moment by moment, help us recognize and be aware of your loving presence in each encounter, in every daily task, and open our hearts to serve and give in small and large ways that present themselves to us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy Spirit, we call on you for healing. Bless nurses, doctors, midwives, chaplains, counselors, and hospice workers as they care for those in need. We pray for healing for those thousands who are struggling to breathe with coronavirus. We pray for those among our community who are in need of healing. For Vera, Sue, Kathy, Diet, Harriet, Angela. For those undergoing therapy, Becky, Sloan, Chris, Dan, and Robbie. And we pray for the city of Minneapolis and all of us who have witnessed another horrible death at the hands of one who is called to serve and protect. bring justice. Teach us, O Lord, to love one another. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your Spirit of hope. As you have led your saints in all times and places, stir in us the desire to follow their example, leading us from death to new life in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please pray with me the prayer that our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
All right, Trinity Lutheran, this is it. This is the ending song of our service. And this is the interactive portion, so get up out of your chairs. I know you can do it. If you can't, just tap your feet. And you certainly can clap your hands. Take one and another one, and you go like this. And then you keep doing that. And I know we're Lutherans, but it's possible. And this song is one I've loved ever since I was a little girl. Every time I feel the Spirit. And let's go out with joy and full of the Spirit and show this world what the Holy Spirit can do for them and how God's love can come and live through them and give them hope and peace. So let's get dancing.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Above the mountains, my love spoke. Out of this mouth came fire and smoke. And all around me looked so fine. My Lord, if all this was mine. Oh, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Jordan River, chill it cold. Chill the body, but not the soul. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Oh, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray.
Let us pray. O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.